These gloves find a home because of their cut resistance, because of their comfort, and because of the different applications that they can go into and still keep that worker being efficient, reduce injuries, and allow everyone involved in this hand protection program to win by keeping work moving forward in a positive manner.
This video is brought to you by SHOWA, always innovating, never imitating. If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hello and welcome to Tooling Up. I'm your host, Toni Neary, and I'm so glad that you've joined us today. Before we get to today's guest, here's your reminder to click those like and subscribe buttons so you never miss an episode. Today, we're diving into next-generation metalworking gloves, and we've got Brian Moseley, a fan favorite and returning guest. He's the technical manager at SHOWA. Brian, welcome back to Tooling Up.
Thank you for the invitation back. It's always good to be with you, Toni, and discuss some hand protection. Looking forward to the things that we go over today for the metalworking applications.
And Brian, Tooling Up viewers know this is not your first show here. It's not even your second, but we also know how passionate you are about gloves. So let's get into it. When it comes to metalworking, safety and performance go hand in hand, pun intended. When designing gloves for these tough environments, what's most important to get right?
You know, there's three main things, because in the cut resistant lineup, you have different challenges. You're trying to offer people, you know, a cut resistant glove, but you're also trying to, offer comfort as well. And when we go into designing these types of products, the first thing that we look at is the cut resistance itself. And I know that sounds funny, but we do the testing because you always want to be able to compare apples to apples, as they say. So some cut gloves may have an A3 rating. Some may have an A5 rating. So that's going to be one of the three things that we look at. The second thing that we're going to look at that's often overlooked is the grip of the glove. Many times cut happens because you have a poor grip in the glove. And when that either sheet metal or, a sharp metal edge slides through the glove because of poor grip, that can cause the laceration through the film and to the person themselves. So we want to make sure that we design a very good grip. And then the third thing is comfort. To get good cut resistance, you have to use tough materials many times. Things like stainless steel, fiberglass, and these are typically not items that you want to find in your socks or t-shirts. So we take great care in being able to put them and employ them into the glove, but be able to do it in such a way that is comfort to the end user. Because as we both know, a glove that's not worn is not being protective in any fashion whatsoever.
Absolutely. And today we're going to talk about three gloves that deliver on all three points. And let's start with the 581. And I have to tell you, there's stainless steel in here and you would never know it. What makes this glove so special?
Well, Toni, with every glove, it's not just one thing. But in the 581, it delivers a high cut level 5 rating in a lightweight design. When you think of a cut level 5, you don't really think about the dexterity and the weight of this glove when it's on your hand. So you're able to work fully and a lot more comfortable. This glove has stainless steel and para-aramid materials. And of course, it has to have that to get the level 5 ratings. So workers are able to have outstanding protection without the stiffness.
Anywhere that dexterity and safety really need to be together. And we love that combo in this glove. But sometimes these jobs involve oil, cutting fluids, or messy conditions, which brings us to the 576. So what's the difference with the 576 when we compare this glove? And what makes it? Because it feels really different.
The 576 is one of my favorite gloves and probably one of the best used, best all-around gloves that we've got. One reason is because of the double dip coating. Now, there's two colors on this glove on the grip, but both of them are nitrile. But there's a big difference between the dips on this glove and the nitrile layers. The gray coating is a continuous film, meaning there's no holes in there for liquids to migrate through. But the black coating is the grip portion of the glove. This is nitrile too, but it's a microfilm. And this allows the glove to absorb the oils or the cutting fluids and allows the nitrile to touch the part even better. If you look on the inside of the glove, it's a totally different color and it's all white. What that is a plating yarn. And SHOWA is committed to watching every liner being made so that plating yarn shows up there consistently and just be white. The reason you want that plating yarn there goes to our number three thing that we talked about in our design inputs, and that's comfort. That white yarn is designed to allow that end user to be able to wear that glove, knowing they've got protection from fluids and cut, but also have something soft against their hand so they enjoy wearing this glove for the long hours that they have to do their job.
And the comfort, protection, and grip are really what it's all about, especially when you're in some of those oily conditions. It's essential to worker safety. But sometimes workers need even more coverage and convenience, and that's where the SHOWA 377 comes in. And it's not just about this pretty blue color. There's some things that stand out immediately about this glove. Let's dive into the 377 and tell me about this showstopper.
The 377SC absolutely has all the options and bells and whistles you can probably put in a cut-resistant glove for oily conditions. Because it first starts that we notice, like you said, that blue coating, a fully dipped continuous film coating. So therefore, the end user is protected from those fluids in every part of their hand, whether it be the upper wrist, whether it be the thumb. That worker can go in those oily conditions and know that they're going to stay protected from those cutting fluids and hydraulic oils. Now, but it also incorporates the microfoam finish just like the 576 did. So it's able to absorb that oil and allow that worker to have great grip.
All right, Brian. So we've seen lightweight dexterity, oil protection, and now full coverage. Where are customers seeing these gloves make the biggest difference?
That's a great question, Toni. And it's very hard to answer except with a very general answer of everywhere, across the board. Like I said earlier, there's no perfect glove out there, but being able to have all the research and development that SHOWA is able to bring forth, all the different types of production processes, we can bring these types of gloves and they can fit whatever job that we find behind the door of that end user in their plant.
Brian, thank you so much for coming back and sharing your passion and expertise with us. The takeaway is clear. SHOWA's gloves provide safer hands, stronger performance, and a better bottom line.
Thank you for the opportunity, Toni.
It was great hanging out with Brian again today. And for more information on how SHOWA can help keep your team safe, visit www.mscdirect.com/products/SHOWA-cut-resistant. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss an episode. Thanks, and we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level. And subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.